Hey up, Duck, we're back. And Adam sent me a video. And I was like, what? So I'm going to show you the video because, you know.
I have one thing to say. You better overwork.
No. No, 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 no.
Wait. Kinder good.
Not good. Not good. Not good. Not good. You should not be putting gel polish on your fingers. Do you know why? Because you're going to get an allergic reaction if you keep doing that. It's not good. It's not designed to go on skin. It's designed to go on nails. Don't get me wrong. I can understand why they're doing it. Yeah, it's like a hack. But no.
The reason I send it to you is because it's got 25 million views.
25 million views?
That video.
What?
And I was just like, that's dangerous.
It is dangerous, you know?
It's
yeah.
On a channel, it's on a page or a channel that has like a million people following it.
Mm-hmm.
And I was just, gobsmacked that they would have let that stay there. So, you know, it's wrong.
It's very unprofessional. It's very unprofessional. So, with that in mind, I'm going to show you how you can do some easy French nails. A few little hacks in here, so keep watching. So before we do the French, we're going to lay down a background colour. I've got a few selections of our nude colours, and we've not really used No Filter a lot. And you know, these really pale pink nudes are really on trend at the minute, and No Filter is definitely that colour. So I am going to put down base coat on all of my nails first, and then I'm going to show you some nudes, and then we'll do the hacks. So we're using the Aliana hand again. No model today. No back chat. It's great. When you're doing your base coat, very, very, very thin layer. It does not need to be thick. Super thin. Right, so when you think your brush has got not enough product on, that's probably the right amount to put on. Right, let's cure them. So, No Filter. So it's a nice pale nude. These are really, really on trend at the minute. We'll do two coats of this. I mean, I like this colour on its own as well. You know, if you've got somebody that really can't decide what they want on the nails, put a bit of No Filter on. Right, so we've got Hayley, which is, you can see instantly is a warmer nude. Birthday Suit, it's ever so slightly darker and more of a lavender undertone to it. So it's slightly cooler, but a shade darker. And then Ruth is a lot more peachy. Second coat of colour. So we've got No Filter, Hayley, Birthday Suit, Ruth. So there are a few different ways we can do this. I'm going to go through the different ways. If you have a short nail, as in salon size or like sporty nail length, see the video we just seen, put yourself a glove on, Duck. It needs to be quite a tight glove. It needs to be fitting well. Yeah, then you can put your white or whatever color French that you're doing on your thumb with a glove. And then,
is this really gonna work?
You imagine it's a short nail though, lad.
Okay.
Short nail. Yeah,
it's a very short nail.
But if you've got short square nails, you could use that technique. Okay. Do not put it on your skin, please. Just don't do it. It's not good. So that's the only way you can really do that. And you can't really do it on, if it was a pointy nail or something like that, yeah, you can then move up the sides and everything like that. But the only problem with doing this is, can you see the bulk? You get like a lump at the end.
We can see it from here, and I'm like on a weird angle.
Yeah, so that's what you get. You get a bulk of product. It's never going to cure properly. So, because it's too thick. But if you're, you know, if that's what you really want to do, then, you know what I mean? Use a glove. Just use a glove. So, I'm going to show you another one. So we've got this old beaten up jelly stamper. We used this in a video where, it went a bit crazy, that video, didn't it? It's pretty cool. But what you can do is...
Oh, was that the crackle video?
Crackle video.
Oh.
Right, product on. Then, what I've learned from when I've done this before is, instead of going directly into the product, go start there. And then hopefully the product should not go under the nail. Still not perfect. Smile line, jelly stamper style. And again, the only thing is, I feel like there's always too much product on there. So I feel like we'd have to come through and kind of drag off a little bit of product and clean it off the brush. So as much as these hacks, you know, they work to a certain degree, they are not perfect. And I would still want to then come up the side. See how the side's slightly round here? I would want to come up with a lily liner, just go into that excess product and get it nice and sharp. I even feel like the smile line could be a little bit better. But if you're doing your non-dominant hand, you're using your non-dominant hand, sorry, then yes, you could use this technique.
Pretty much just good if you're doing your own nails.
Yeah, if you're doing your own nails, yeah. But then look, there's still a lot of product on there.
And what about underneath?
Wow. Not this time, Adam.
Oh, I saw you did something different, mind.
We put the product on. I mean, let's put less product on. You know, just for those people that are going, you put too much on. I'm sure there will be people saying that. Start in front of the product. All the way up. It's too fiddly, man, I think.
And then you press down and in. Yeah.
Oh, that one's not bad. If you're doing a little nail. But I feel like I haven't got enough. Yeah, I feel like I haven't got enough product to spread. Let's try. No, look, there's not enough product. Yeah, and I think it's quite bubbly as well from all with the pushing back and everything like that. But anyway, there's one. Right, let's cure that one. And then I find this is the easiest way. We're gonna hand paint and we're gonna put some of the colour down on a palette. So whatever colour that you're using, pull your lily liner through, and then we're going to start where we would imagine the natural nail finishes and do like a 45 degree angle. So create like an A. Oh, there's an anime with an A on that. I forgot.
It's like an H. Like
the high end H.
Does? Hyundai H, it does look like that.
Oh, it does?
I still love my Hyundai.
Then what we're going to do is pull from the middle and just curve up. Just want to sneak up a little higher there. And then we just curve that corner. And then you can get your brush from your bottle and fill in the rest. Now, look how quick that was in comparison to the jelly one. That was a lot quicker, isn't it? And we'll do two coats of that. So let's get that curing. There was another video I watched. Oh my God. And I bet I can't find it again on TikTok of somebody using full cover press on tips. You know, the ones you get from like Boots or Walmart or wherever. The ones that are already painted. Using gel, like gel to put them on with, putting it under the lamp. There ain't no way that all that gel is cured. So do not do that because they're already coloured.
Ah, right. So the
and
they're not
the light won't get through. Mm. You know, you've got specially designed ones that are for that are semi-transparent. But if it is not transparent, like a red nail that's already painted. from, you know, the pharmacy or wherever, the beauty place, wherever you've got it from. Anyway.
They were using gel to put it on. Why? Why wouldn't they just use glue?
I know.
Or the sticky tab things that you get.
Yeah, sticky tabs are great for that.
Yeah.
Ask Janet Jackson, she knows. So we'll do two coats. So now we've got this guide. We've already got it there. We can just follow this with the brush. You can even redraw that A if you want to. But the second time round, it's a lot easier. I'm just going to turn the hand so I can get my angle. And what I do is I make sure there's a bit of gel polish in front of my brush and I push that up. So that's why I kind of bounce, because I want to push that up. And you're definitely going to have a thinner application because it's far more controlled. I remember getting a white, you still be able to get these white pencils from Avon.
Mm-hmm.
Like a wax pencil that you put under your nail to make your free edge look white. I mean, as soon as you wash your hands, it went. So it's a bit pointless, but...
Sorry, say that again.
People get this wax pencil,
uh-huh.
Like a white wax pencil,
yeah.
But like a white eyeliner.
Right.
And you used to put it under the free edge of your natural nail,
uh-huh.
To make them look more white.
Yeah.
From Avon. Okay. I used to do that. I thought it was the business. But yeah, once you wash your hands a few times, it's gone. And then, see, I think that is nicer, more controlled, better shape. I am just going to top coat these two because I'm noticing I am touching them and I don't want to keep touching them. I do think choosing the right colour for your nail bed colour, so your nude colour, is so important, because you'll notice with these two, they are two different colours, but you'll notice that the white on the one that I'm painting now stands out so much more because it's got a greater contrast. So it depends whether you want a high contrast or not. You know, are you going for more of a natural look? I am sick of bits of fluff. Like you're not invited. We didn't invite the fluff.
Your name's not down, you're not coming in.
Yeah, the fluff just thinks it's party time here. Right, I'm going to show you how I do my toes. Not on camera, I'm not going to show you my toes. Right. I always have French toes. Regardless of anything, I will always have French toes. I love French toes. I like French toast, but I like French toes. I just think they look clean. They go with every sandal that you put on. So I'm going to show you how I do it. Now, obviously, my toes are not this long. However, I did put a picture on the other day and I thought, God, you look like you've got tingers. Tingers. Toe fingers. Right, so I'm just going to get a little bit more product. Kind of want like a blob. Not like this. This is too flat. This is way too flat. I want like a raised blob. And I'm going to use the design needle end of the Palmy Picker Upper. And I'm going to use it like a pen. This is exactly how I do my toes. It is so easy. So I literally draw it on. And especially when you're doing toes, you're only covering quite a small surface, but it does work with long nails as well. So I draw it on like that. But when I'm doing my toes, I can generally just fill this in like this. Yeah, but we're not going to do that because we've got quite a bit to fill in. So we're going to use the brush because we've already got the smile line. We've done the hard work. There you are. That is easy, isn't it? Oh. And because you use it like a pen and you haven't got bristles of a brush flopping around and you're having to control, because you're using the Palmy Picker Upper tool, you just use it like a pen. It's so easy. So easy, honest.
Ooh, even I could do that.
I think you could, Adam.
Mm-hmm. Maybe. Try me toes later on.
Oh, yeah. I'll come in tomorrow and you'll have French toes. So we can do a second coat. So you could either go in with your brush, or if you're still a little bit wary, you can go again and do your second coat and still draw your line while you curve, your little smile line. And then you'll stretch this product down as well, so it's not too thick. So, top coat. I know they're all slightly different shapes, but you know, you're getting the gist, you know what I mean? It's a few different ways to do it there. The next way, next method in my madness, I'm gonna use the Adam 3D brush. Cause he's 3D, 5D. Right, so we're gonna get the white. So this is white out. We're just gonna go, oh, we'll have a little go of doing one with the brush. Doesn't really matter if it is. If the fluff doesn't do one, I am literally gonna scream. So that's a really, really rubbish smile line, isn't it? So you need a lint-free pad, and then we'll need clean-up solution. Your Adam 3D brush, paddle it out. And we're gonna come in, so it's now damp with the solution, but only damp, and we're just gonna sweep out. So you're gonna go from the middle and sweep it out. So you wanna go higher than you want the actual smile line, because you need room to be able to sweep that product into that smile line. It does give you a more rounded smile line. Got there, another smile line. Let's give that a cure. And I'm just gonna do a second coat, really thin, just for more pigment. And you have a guide already. With this one, you don't even need to go right up to that smile line, because it's already heavily pigmented in that area, because we've sweeped out and pushed product. We've pushed the gel polish into that area. So let's have a look at them all. So they're all slightly different. And my favourite one is probably the centre two. I like both of them too, really. Which one's your favourite? And what hacks have you tried? Comment below, I want to try more hacks. As long as they are safe and it's not gel polish on somebody's thumb. Because that's a no-no, duck. I hope you've enjoyed this video. I hope it's helped you to perfect your French. And everything I've used today will be listed below. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Ta-ra, duck! So we're going to hand paint, but what we're going to do...